welcome to our Family and Youth Sunday. Thank you for coming out this morning to worship with us and those watching online. And we pray that you'll be blessed as we worship in a little different way this morning. But we truly believe that God will still be glorified and honored today. Just a few announcements before Awaken starts with our worship. There is coffee and conversation this week from 9:30 to 11 on Wednesday morning. Home League is at 7. We think the contact went out and said 7:30, which was a misprint. Home League is still at 7 on Tuesday night. Next Sunday is Remembrance Day weekend. And next Sunday we will have members of the Canadian Legion with us. And if you wear any type of uniform and want to come to next Sunday morning service in uniform, please feel free to do so. And these are in the foyer on the welcome table. Christmas is coming. It's November. Just as well to accept the fact. And so on December the 1st, we're having our Tree of Memories. So please see the sheet out in the foyer and complete it and pass it in if you wish to participate in that event. And that's enough for announcements. And now Awaken is going to lead us in worship.
Saves us and is worthy of all of our praises. Help us sing Hosanna, praises rising.
This is rising, eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away.
Here, Lord. This next song is for anyone who may find themselves with many, sometimes seemingly unbearable, struggles in their lives. Instead of trying desperately to deal with things on our own, God is telling us that in the storms of our lives, we need to just be held by Him and put our trust in Him. Focus on the words and feel free to come to the altar and pray about it as we sing.
Next chorus speaks of what happens when we accept Jesus into our lives. We become new creations through Him.
I'm a new creation. I'm a brand new man. All things are fine.
awaken for that beautiful worship. Just be held. The first time I heard that one, but isn't the words just beautiful? Stop holding on and just be held. Scripture tells us to bring all our burdens to Him, to cast them on Him because He cares for us, to let them go, to surrender, to abandon. That's been a word God is speaking to me through the fall, to abandon to Him. Not always easy, but oh, what release when we can do it. Stop holding on and just be held. Thank you so much, Awaken, for that song this morning. We're to come before the Lord in prayer, and we're going to sing the beautiful words, Refiner's Fire. My heart's one desire is to be holy, set apart for you, Lord. I choose to be holy. It has to be intentional. It just doesn't happen. Set apart for you, my master, ready to do your will. We have a number in our core this morning that needs our prayers. Those who are grieving, those who are sick, those who are hurting. You know the names. You know the needs this morning. And we just pray that God will draw near to them. We have Naomi Reed and Roberta Pritchett in hospital. We just pray that God will be with them there today. And I'm sure there are others that are on your heart this morning. So as we're going to sing this through, and then we'll have prayer together. I pray, God, that that's the prayer of each of our hearts here this morning, that it's not about us, but it's all about you. And once again, you're asking us to surrender, to abandon to you, to just be held. And often, God, that's easier said than done. But I pray, Lord, today that we will experience your faith and your peace, your comfort and your strength in amazing ways. That we will know that you are God who loves us more than anything, and you have nothing but mercy and grace for us today. God, may we each experience that afresh today. Lord, you've heard the concerns upon our hearts. We pray for Naomi and Roberta in hospital today. Draw near to them. May they know that they are being prayed for, and may they feel the strength of our prayers. We pray for those that are grieving today, God. Draw near to them. Walk this difficult journey with them, God. And may they sense your presence and your peace beyond human understanding, beyond to them all that they need you to be today. For those that are sick, Lord, and dealing with issues and mental health issues, God, and concerns upon their hearts, God, may they give it to you today, knowing that you can do all things. And that you can do more than we could ever dream or imagine. We thank you for this opportunity this morning to worship. Lord, we thank you for our young people that are involved. And Lord, we pray that all that is said and done here this morning will be for your honor and your glory. And may we be blessed as we enter in. We pray these things in thy name. Amen.
Time for tithes and offering. I'll ask the ushers to stand for prayer. Do we have ushers? Yeah, okay. I wasn't sure. Okay, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for the opportunity that we can come into your house and worship you. Thank you for the youth who are participating in the service and that they're willing to give up their talents to honor and glorify you together. Pray now for the opportunity for us all to participate through the giving of our money to glorify you and to further the kingdom together. Pray this in your name. Amen.
Stand as we sing song number 573, Be Thou My Vision, Be Thou My Wisdom, Be Thou My True Word, Be Thou Ever With Me and I With Thee, Lord. Be Thou My Great Father and I, the True Son, Be Thou Me Dwelling and I With Thee One. Let's stand.
Jesus entered and walked through Jericho, there was a man there. His name was Zacchaeus, the head tax man and quite rich. He wanted desperately to see Jesus, but the crowd was in the way. He was a short man and couldn't see over the crowd. So he ran on ahead and climbed up in a sycamore tree so he could see Jesus when he came by. When Jesus got to the tree, he looked up and said, "Zacchaeus, hurry down. Today is my day to be the guest in your home." Zacchaeus scrambled out of the tree, hardly believing his good luck, delighted to see Jesus home with him. Everyone who saw the incident was indignant and grumped. "What business does he have getting cozy with this crook?" Zacchaeus just stood there, a little stunned. He stammered apologetically, "Master, I give away half my income to the poor, and if I'm caught cheating, I pay for four times the damages." Jesus said, "Today is salvation day in this home. Here he is, Zacchaeus, son of Abraham, for the Son of Man came to find and restore the lost."
Thank you.
Nothing we do isn't through ourselves, but through Christ, through you in us. Thank you this morning, God, for that assurance. Now, as Major Morgan comes with your word in a slightly different method and mold this morning, we just pray that you will bless him and that we will be attentive, Holy Spirit, to what you speak to our hearts this morning. We pray this in thy name. Amen.
The Romans. I'm not sure what the Romans are going to do. I'm in so much trouble. I don't know what just happened. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm in so much trouble. The Romans. Oh, I'm Zacchaeus. I'm not sure if you've heard, but a lot of things happened today. A lot of things that happened today that I did not expect happened today. And now I'm in so much trouble. So much trouble. I'm not sure how to get out of this. You see, a little bit of backstory. The Romans were watching me. As a boy, they were all over where I was and what I was doing. It's just amazing. When I was in the bag's garden in Kettle Cove, stealing carrots, they were there watching me.
Georgia Sweet Treats, and they saw me steal that brand. They were watching me. And then as I got older, and going to different places, and taking and sneaking in and out, their eyes were just watching me. I could not get away from these people, the Romans. And then when I got a little bit older, they brought me to the high court. And they sat me in front of the high guard. And he looked at me. He said, "Boy, do I have a proposition for you." He said, "I'm going to make you rich." And of course, as a thief, and a guy that was just nowhere, going nowhere in life, that was an amazing deal. He's going to make me rich. Rich. I wouldn't have to steal the sweet bread or the carrots from the gardens anymore. What would I have to do? And he said, "I'm going to make you a tax collector. You're going to work for me. And you're going to go to all these businesses. And you're going to collect taxes. But I only want this much. And you can collect whatever you want for yourself." I'm like, "Really?" And the guard said, "Yeah, as long as we get this, you can have this." Up my alley. So I started. And I would go to Mr. Jones's store and say, "Need the money. Taxes are due." And he'd give me the taxes, and I'd say with this hand, "A little bit more." And I pocketed that. It was a good life. It was incredible. I had everything I wanted. I could take my darling on trips. We'd jump in the old boat, and I'd get her to paddle across the lake, and we'd have a picnic. It was amazing. Oh, I'm in so much trouble. I'm in so much trouble. And I've done this for years. Made a life, a living. Then I heard about this guy. This guy that just showed up. Jesus. So on my daily travels around Jericho and doing these things, I heard the stories of how he healed the blind. He made people walk. He cured leprosy? Like, what's with that? But they were just stories. And then the stories started getting more and more and more that maybe he was the Messiah. That he could change lives. He ain't changing my life. I've got it too good. I don't want nothing to do with this guy. He ain't changing my life. Then one day it happened. It happened. News spread that he was coming to my town. What would Jesus want in my town? What's he doing in my town? So the people were all in a hustle and bustle, getting ready for Jesus to come, the miracle worker, the so-called Messiah. What's the deal with this guy? I just went about doing my business, making some money for myself. And then I got curious. But the Romans were still watching me. They still saw what I was doing. So I had to be careful. See, I was a short man. I'm very short. And I couldn't really see above these taller people. So I had to get creative because I just wanted to see who this guy was. Didn't really want him to see me, but I wanted to see him. So as the crowds came that day, I was kind of, can't see nothing. They were giants. So I beat it down the road. I found this tree, the sycamore tree. It's an incredible tree. And I said, "I think I'll get up there and just kind of hide in among the branches just so I can see who this guy was." But I couldn't allow the Romans to see me because, you know, the Romans. So I went down, kind of climbed up the tree, settled into a branch, had some of that good bread, a few carrots. It's absolutely delicious. And then the commotion started. He was coming. Jesus was coming. He wasn't coming on a big parade or anything. He was just walking down with his stick and a bag, just carrying what he owned. I was intrigued. This was the miracle worker? This is the guy that healed people? This is the person that changed lives? Really? Changed lives? This guy? Born of a carpenter? Seriously, dude? Anyway, he came, and I nestled into the branches so nobody would see me. And people were around him. Intrigued, he stopped just below me. And I was like, oh no, what is this? He looked up. He caught my eyes. He saw me. Jesus saw me. And in a quiet voice, get out of that tree. Zach, he knew my name? How did this guy know my name? Come down from that tree, Zacchaeus. I was frozen. Not just a Roman saw me, but Jesus saw me. Called me by name. So without even realizing what I was doing, I jumped out of the tree. And he looked at me. And he said, I'm going to your house for dinner. Whoa, 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 whoa. You can't come to my house for dinner. Lisa don't know you're coming. She ain't going to be happy with me if I bring guests. Not happening. But he looked into my eyes. None of that mattered. And we went to my house. And we ate. And I was captivated by how he spoke. He spoke about the kingdom of God. He spoke about changing my life and going to a new life. He saw me. That encounter changed my life. But there was a problem. I was a thief. I had all this money. But he didn't care. He saw me, and he loved me. Jesus saw me, but there was a problem that I had to work out. I was changed. He left. We gave him some leftovers for his journey. And I said to my wife, I gotta make this right. Something just happened. I gotta make this right. I can't be a tax collector no more. And I had climb that ladder, and I was going to be at the top. Matthew would have been so proud of me. I was going to be the top tax collector. Now I was unemployed. The Romans weren't going to be happy. But something prompted in my heart that the money I had stolen and taken, I should give it to the poor. I should give it back. I don't think my wife was too keen on that. She had a trip planned. So I said, I will take this money and I would give it back more than I had took. Jesus saw me. And not only did he see me, but all my faults, everything that I was and is, he invited me to the table to eat with him, the Messiah, eating with a sinner. I mean, there were people around that just couldn't understand it, didn't get it. Who is this man eating with sinners? It didn't matter. He saw me and invited me to sit and to eat with him.
At the table of the Lord, I will feast at the table of the Lord. I won't hunger anymore at his table. I will feast at the table. His yoke is easy, his burden light.
Thank you, Georgia, for that message, that we're all welcome at the table of the Lord. And that's a wonderful thing to know. So we're going to conclude our service this morning, and we're going to sing the song, Tell Me the Stories of Jesus. Tell me the old, old story. Of on seeing things above, of Jesus and his glory, of Jesus and his love. Tell me the story simply, as to a little child, for I am weak and weary and helpless and defiled. Sing this through, please. We can stand.
Jesus and his glory, of Jesus and his love.
Wasn't it a wonderful morning worshiping with our young people? Let's give them some encouragement. Thank you to all who participated. Thank you, YP Band, under the leadership of Nathan. Thank you, Awaken, under the leadership of Danny. They all did a fabulous job. Thank you, Christina, for reading the scripture. Yes? Everyone did a great job. Georgia, the solo was beautiful. It was all God-inspired this morning. I truly believe that. And remember this morning that you are seen. That you are seen. When you think no one knows and no one cares, you are truly seen by God himself this morning. Our singing benediction is one I think that Nathan loves, Praise God I'm Saved, because he sings it every time he has the opportunity to sing it. We're going to pray, and then we're going to stand and sing together, Praise God I'm Saved. Father, thank you for this opportunity to worship today. Thank you for the opportunity to come into your house, to this sanctuary, and be together as a church and as a core family. Bless the young people that participated. Lord, keep them close to you, we pray. Now as we go out into the hall to share fellowship and food together, we thank you for those that have given, and Lord, we thank you for the hands who prepared it, and be amongst us as we share in conversation, and may it be sweet. Praying these things in thy name, and all God's people said,
amen.
And when you get out there and wonder if grace is saved, I just said it. Let's stand together as we sing Praise God.
Thank you.